terms on the calendar year, so technically expires on December 31st. We give a grace period. In years past, that period extended out to April 1st. Now, that's a little bit cumbersome on the new league, just takes longer than it really needs to. And so we've kind of, with the new system we've got in place, we've been getting the renewal packages out in mid to late December, and we just have been able to use the same preparation time to get a February 1st delinquent deadline. So what we're asking for is just officially codify that new deadline to correspond to actual practice.
Chuck, I wonder why we don't have it at December the 31st. Then, I mean, I know that's the data to me, that's the end of why not? You have to renew your license like you do your driving license and pay your taxes. I mean, why do we give this grace period? Like we leave the money on the table, financing for 2 months.
Well, the business license is based on gross receipts of the business. And so they need some reasonable period of time to total up their books again.
Business license will be issued on a 12-month basis. In other words, it's really not lost revenue. It's just you're not collecting it until.
Correct. Yeah, it's the same.
The only thing you, the potential loss would be, and that's why April is worse, is there were businesses trying to cover up. They were marginal or thinking they might go out of business anyway. Well, why not operate the first 4 months of the next year free and then not just renew your license? So, this helps reduce that. That's really your only risk. Someone who would go out of business and just not pay.
What if the business is getting extension? The extension doesn't come to April 15th.
I mean, we've been doing this anyway for the last time. You've already built it. You built it in November this year.
Right.
We got the February deadline, so they're already accustomed to this. It's just the ordinance set up.
It wasn't an experience. Right. I mean, it was just the fact that our ordinance stated they had a
yeah.
And what we want to do is send that back.
Right. But and they'll actually have more time from when they're billed to when they have to pay, so it's not an imposition on the business. And we actually accept the most recent, whether it's recent or out, so it's not like, okay, well, nobody can get the taxes done by 12/31, well, therefore, all they have to do is the most recent set that they have, so it's the prior year, it's the prior year, so whatever their CPA submits is accepted as long as it's the most recent.
Correct. This will take prior year tax return, which is what we prefer, but in the absence of that, we also take a letter on letter head from an accounting firm.
So it really shouldn't affect the businesses.
As a business that pays this February